Right, we're just kind of out here investigating how sheep behave around dogs. How are they behaving with the dogs, and then how are they behaving with the robot dogs? How does that differ? Out here, Craig's walked us through the way sheep work. They've got their bubble, a different temperament, they react differently to different colored dogs. There's so many things that go into it that he's kind of guided us through, and it's really helping us develop what direction we want to take the software for the project and what considerations we need to make.
We're here with the robotic dogs, particularly to herd sheep, and see how the animal and the machine interact with each other. Now, this is our first attempt of using this technology. We want to look beyond and see what's possible, and potentially also encourage our students to think outside the box and to consider the potential of this technology. Phil has studied now for 4 years. Projects like this allow him to combine all this knowledge into a particular application and see the impact that his 4 years of study can have once he goes out into the world, and how he can transform industries, transform applications, and develop new technology.
Yeah, I was blown away by how agile they are and the way that they can turn, twist, very similar to how a dog moves. You're 2 years into training a dog before it can go out and do a job for you. A lot of people can't do that. A lot of people, A, don't have the time, and B, don't have the skill to train a dog. You don't need to train yourself to do it either.
I hadn't considered this before, but after getting into the dog project, through like object detection, through the robot dog as a platform, as a motion platform, is amazing, and that can just be used in so many different ways. It's incredible.